Hello students, welcome to my next video. Today we will learn sources of data collection. I, Dr. Honevale, welcome you all. Subject is business research methods. This is online lecture series. Don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon for further notifications. This is lecture number 19, sources of data collection. Learning questions for today's session. What is the concept of secondary data? And what is the concept of primary data? So we will try to learn the basic concepts, common sources, pros and cons of secondary data and primary data. So we will start with methods of data collection. There are two methods of data collection, secondary data and primary data. We will start with the concept of secondary data. We will start with the meaning. Meaning of secondary data. Secondary data means data that was collected by someone other than the user or the researcher. Common sources of secondary data: census, organizational records, official websites of organizations or firms, various reference books, government departments, their official reports and websites, various periodicals and referred journals, and various articles published in the referred journals, thesis or reports published by other researchers. These are various common sources of secondary data. So we will understand now the concept of secondary data. Secondary data analysis can save time and would otherwise be spent on collecting data, particularly in case of the quantitative data. It can provide larger and higher quantitative databases that would be unfeasible for any individual researcher to collect that data on their own. In addition, analysts of the social economic change considered secondary data essential, since it is impossible to conduct a new survey that can adequately capture past changes or various developments. However, secondary data analysis can be less useful in marketing research, as data may be outdated or incorrect. So this is the concept of secondary data. Moving on, we will understand characteristics of secondary data. It is a summary of a book or a set of records. Collection of secondary data is less time consuming. Third characteristics: the data cannot be personally checked or verified. It provides a large database of information, and in some cases secondary data is not reliable. These are various characteristics of secondary data. Moving on, we will understand now issues to be considered for secondary data. There are three issues: adequacy, reliability, and consistency. Now we will understand each and every issues in detail. We will start with adequacy. Insufficiency or adequacy. Secondary data may or may not be sufficient for the researcher to be conducted. There may be lack of accuracy in previous data. There is possibility that available data has different objectives and scope, so may not be sufficient to fulfill the need of the present study. So this is one of the big issues in secondary data. Now we will start with reliability. Data reliability is a state that exists when the data is sufficiently complete and error-free to be convincing for its purpose and context. In addition to being reliable, data must also meet other tests of evidences. The third issue is consistency. Data consistency refers to the use of usability of the data and is often taken for granted in the single site of environment. Data consistency problems may arise even in a single site environment during recovery situations when back copies of the production data are used in the place of original data. These are various issues in secondary data. Now we will try to understand various frauds, that is advantages of secondary data. Secondary data is available from other sources and may already have been used in previous research, making it easier to carry out the further research. It is time-saving and cost-effective. The data was collected by someone else other than the researcher. That's why it is time-saving. Then next advantage is administrative data and census data may cover both larger and much smaller samples of population in details. A clear benefit of using secondary data is that much of the background work needed has already been carried out, such as literature reviews or case studies. Further advantages: data may have been used in published texts and statistical elsewhere, and the data could already be promoted in the media or being in useful for personal contacts. Secondary data usually have a pre-established degree of validity and reliability, which need not be re-examined by the researcher who is reusing such type of data. So reliability and validity are already calculated. Secondary data is the key concept of data enrichment, which is where database from the secondary sources are connected to the research database to improve its precision by adding key objectives, attributes, and values. Secondary data can provide a baseline for primary research to compare the collected primary data results to, and it can also be useful in the research design. These are various advantages of secondary data. Then we will see cons, that is disadvantages of secondary data. The data may be out of date or outdated or inaccurate for the current study of the research. If using the data or data collected for different research purposes, it may not cover those samples of population researcher wants to examine or not sufficient details. The third disadvantage is administrative data, which is not originally collected by the researcher or research, may not be available in the usual research format or may be difficult to get access to. So these are various disadvantages of secondary data. Now we will see the concept of primary data. We will start with the definition. Primary data is the data collected for the first time by the researcher through direct efforts and experiences for the purpose of specific investigation. Primary data is collected by the researcher for the first-hand sources using various methods like surveys, interviews, experiments, questionnaires, and so on. It is collected with the research project in mind directly from the primary sources. So the characteristics are primary means first or original or direct. So primary data is the data that is collected from a source by the researcher himself or herself in a raw format. Then primary data are created by witnesses or researcher who experiences the events. Then primary data are actual records from the past in the original form without interpretation. Primary sources needed to be interpreted. They document events, people, and viewpoints of that time. These are various characteristics of primary data. Pros of primary data, that is advantages of primary data. The primary data are original and relevant to the topic of the research studied by, the degree of accuracy is very high. Primary data is that data that can be collected from a number of ways, that is interviews, telephone surveys, focus groups, etc. And common sources of primary data are surveys, observations, experiments, questionnaire, and personal interviews. Next advantage, it can be also collected across the national borders through email and post. It can include a large population and a wider geographical area coverage. Moreover, primary data is current, and it can better give a realistic view to the researcher about the topic under consideration. Then reliability of primary data is very high because these are collected by the concerned and reliable parties. Now we will understand disadvantages, that is cons of primary data. For collection of primary data where interview is to be conducted, the coverage is limited, and for wider coverage, a more number of researchers are required. A lot of time and efforts are required to collect the data. By that time, the data collected, analyzed, and report is ready, the problem of the researcher becomes very serious or may be outdated. So the purpose of researcher may be defeated. It has design problems like how to design the surveys. The questions must be simple to understand and respond for the respondents. Some respondents do not give timely response. Sometimes the respondents may give fake or socially acceptable and sweet answers to cover up the reality. With more people, time and efforts, involvement, the cost of data collection goes on high. The importance of the research may go down. In some primary data collection methods, there are no control over the data collection. Incomplete questionnaires always given the negative impact on the researcher. Trained persons are required for the data collection. Inexperienced persons in data collection may give inadequate data for research. These are the various cons of primary data. What we have learned today? Learning outcomes from today's sessions. We have understood the concept of data in research, and we have understood the primary data and secondary data in detail. What is next? In my next video, we will understand levels of measurement, that is nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Till then, keep thinking, keep learning, keep watching my channel. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment, and turn on the bell icon for further notifications. All the best for your studies. These are some references I have used for preparing this video. Thank you.